Something Happened to Our Planet: Kids Tackle the Climate Crisis by Marion Solano and Marietta Collins. I'm worried something bad is happening to our planet. Dad says the air and oceans are getting warmer, and that's why storms and fires are worse now than they were before. Mom says these changes won't hurt us now, but a warmer planet will make life harder in the future, when I'm as old as Grandma. Grandma says humans hurt the planet and humans can fix it, but I'm just one human. The planet is so big, and I'm small. What can I do? Ants are smaller than you, said my little brother Cameron. A colony of ants can move a mountain of dirt, said Dad, and they help the plants grow. How? I asked. The colony makes a deep nest in the ground, led by the queen ant, said Dad. The ants turn the soil, which helps water and food to reach the plants. I thought about how much I could do if I was an ant. But what's the first thing an ant needs? Other ants. I asked my friends to be part of my colony to help the planet. At first, I thought I'd be the leader, since it was my idea. But we ended up having three leaders: me, Carter, and Tally. We're humans after all, not ants. Now, we had to decide what we could do to help the planet. I already knew about pollution. How do we make the air cleaner? I asked Grandma. Plant trees, she said. I was confused, but trees are part of nature. How can they help? We are part of nature too. If we do our part, nature heals itself. She explained how trees clean the air by taking in the harmful gases humans make and giving us the oxygen we need to breathe. The trees were working hard to save the earth. What could we do to help them? We wanted to do more, to do something that would help the planet now. Something big. Oceans are big, said Carter. We named our group the Earth Patrol. The trees we planted were as small as Cameron, but we knew they would be big one day. We asked our teacher how we could help the ocean. Have you ever seen a coral reef? Miss Nethmi asked. She showed us a picture on the internet. My eyes stayed stuck on the screen. The coral reef had thousands of colorful plants and creatures. They need each other and the water to survive. She said that warmer water hurts the coral and turns it white. What's making the water so warm? Asked Tally. The fuels we burn to make and move the things we use and throw away. Even the cans and water bottles we recycle? Asked Carter. It's better to reuse and recycle, said Miss Nethmi. It uses less fuel. Maybe we can look for things that we can reuse here at school, I said. Perfect, said Miss Nethmi. Your group can start our school's first climate plan. Carter, Tally, and I gathered the Earth Patrol. Let's look everywhere in school to get ideas, I said. We looked in the classrooms, library, cafeteria, hallways, bathrooms, and playground. We even looked in the trash cans. It was easy to find the room with the biggest trash cans. We talked about what we could reuse at school. In the end, we decided on lunch trays that could be washed and used again. We wrote our idea and reasons why on a piece of paper, which we did not throw away. Mrs. Nethmi went with us to the principal's office when we were ready. We stood tall like trees and showed him our paper. He said he liked our idea, but the school didn't have the money to buy the trays and the extra dishwasher needed to clean them. We were disappointed. When I got home from school, I might have leaned on Mom and cried. I'm human after all, not a tree. But we did not give up. We asked our parents to help us talk about our idea at the next PTA meeting. We called it Trays for the Planet, or TP for short. Cameron loved saying our short name. We talked to my dad's friend, who knows about energy and recycling. We wrote more reasons why our school should buy the trays and the dishwasher. We said students could help collect and stack the trays at the end of lunch. I kept looking at the live feed of the coral reef on my tablet. That's when I read that the plastic we throw away ends up in the ocean and hurts the fish. We went to the PTA meeting. All of us brought our parents, and Carter brought his cousin, who is a newspaper reporter. A lot of teachers were there. We waved at Miss Nethme. We took turns reading aloud all the reasons why we thought the school should buy reusable trays. When in turn, I was as shaky as a leaf in a rainstorm. The people in the meeting looked so serious. What if they laughed at me? At first, my voice was weak. Then it got stronger. When I was done, I looked into the faces of the grown-ups. I still felt small, but I also felt big. I would like to see a coral reef in real life one day, I said. We all would, said Tally. First, there was silence, then clapping, then waiting. The PTA said yes to trays for the planet. We can start to help the oceans right now. Even better, the kids got the parents and teachers talking about how to help the planet. They are planning a way to get our school's energy from the sun. But here's the best part. Carter's cousin posted a story about our success, and now, other schools may make their own climate plans. We are all part of nature. If we do our part, nature heals itself. The end.